Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing the Abin Jaguar. I finally bought an Abin Jaguar A, and I just want to show you a build that just makes sense on it. Now, when we take a look at the Abin Jaguar Omnipod bonus, you can see we have an Ultra AC 20 jam chance reduction of 15%, as well as a machine gun rate of fire of 20. We ignore the machine guns, but we care about the Ultra AC because we're gonna take one and we're gonna put it into the right side torso. And then we're gonna take a lot of medium pulse lasers and we're gonna put them into the left side torso as well as the left arm. That means that we have a good amount of firepower, 52.5 alpha strike, and if we double tap that machine here, we have 72 damage that we can pump out in a single alpha strike. The drawback of the build is that it is a bit hot-ish. We only have 17 heat sinks to cool the mag down, but in general, it is quite a lot of fun to play because you can just burst down the enemies and they will just, if you shoot them once, if you shoot them twice, they will just try to get away from you, and then you can take that period of time to cool your mech down and then engage again. So it's quite a lot of fun to play. There's also a variation of the build that has everything, even the Ultra Autocannon on the arm here, like everything on the side here, and then the medium pulse lasers on the other arm, but I like this more because we can then strip down this arm and just save some more weight to put more double heat sinks and more ammunition into the mech. So that's gonna be my go-to build for today. We have a bunch of skills too. I also want the UAC jam duration as well as magazine capacity and the laser duration nodes, as you can see. I'm going with the left side of the survivability tree, getting a little bit more armor points, and then maximum cool run. We have 60% radar deprivation, double cool shot, and a UAV to finish the build. And that's it, guys. I wish you all a lot of fun in the two games that are coming now. And if you have that, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you want more of this. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing Rubellite Oasis. We are playing Domination. And I think it is a good idea, a very good idea, to meet up with the Assault Mechs and see what we can do together with them. The Abin Jaguar, I have to say, is not the most sturdy mech in the world. It is rather wide, it has big hitboxes, so it's easy to target. It has the bunny ears sticking out before you can see the enemies. So we have to be very careful with our positioning. Also, when we take a look at this, this is 33% of our heat with one energy only alpha strike. The autocannon will add some more heat on top of that. So especially on hot maps, we have to be somewhat careful with the damage anyway, with the heat anyway, because we can most likely not out-damage all of the enemies. That is the thing. If we are finding ourselves in a tough fighting situation, just bursting the enemies down is usually not an option. That's what I mean. Getting hit already here. Come on. Find another target. Doesn't have to be me, does it? I don't know. Okay, so we are here. We have the assault mechs around, and it seems that they want to keep pushing forward, although that's not a good idea. We have a stealth mech in Echo 4, stealth light mech. Where did he go? There he is. Ah, so close. I should go for the big guys. And that's what I mean. Look at that, my side torso, no, my center torso is hit a lot. Okay, can we kind of somehow get out of this? Okay, that is all we can do now. Oh, I wanted to help out here by staying on this position, but my team is NASCARing away. See, the thing is, we have still one assault mech who is completely disconnected from the rest of the team. I wanted to just give my team some hint that this is a good place to defend, but now they are rotated away from us, so we have to go with them. Sorry, sorry, teammate there. Yeah, now you're coming. Guys, no, this way. Echo 5, left side. Yeah, let's go Echo 5, guys. Let's go, let's go. Yeah, they destroyed our assault mech there. That was... Oh, I hate when that happens. I really wanted to be helpful, and I couldn't. Center on Echo. Good. So, actually, we took a kill back. That's great. Let's see how we can go from here. Enemies are probably all in Echo 5. New target. On the Battlemaster. Arm only, but okay. Dropping that UAV. Battlemaster is caught, guys. Maybe we can follow up on that. I don't want to push over completely. It's too risky for me. I also should be shooting my weapons. Let's go. Yeah. Just made up my mind. Good. That's a side torso down. Perfect. Okay, I need to push in now. That's a kill. I know. So we are behind the enemies. We should capitalize on that. Okay. Trying to see through the smoke. We should be able to catch the Battlemaster. Let's see. I'm alone, more or less. We have one guy there, and they know that I'm coming because of the UAV. Okay. Marauder is going in. That's good. He's going in guns blazing. I can help you. If you don't block me. Okay, you don't want to push any further, it seems. That's a lot of rocks. Okay, I gotta go. That hurt. That hurt a lot. 6-3 though. Let's be aggressive. Nope. Why did my laser fire? I didn't press the button. Okay, so we need to come from another angle. They are watching this very, very keenly. And my center torso is not in a good state anymore, so let's try to find another target that is unaware of our position. Although, I could have stayed there. I could have stayed there easily. Okay, we're gonna go in again. Taking high ground, because the enemies are probably focused on my low ground buddies here. And they won't see me coming from here. Didn't destroy. Wow. Could destroy this guy though. Yeah. Was a bit too quick. My shooting. Okay, no autocannon yet. New target. Guys, it's jammed. We are 9-5. Let's go. Let's try to kill here. 11-5. Last guy. Is the quick draw? Is it or is it not? It doesn't seem to be like it. No, there was still an assault mech in Delta 5 last seen there. So we destroyed everybody here. And I do believe that the last guy is in Delta 5. I mean, at the very least, the guy is out of the circle. He's still alive. Here comes the Warhammer 2C. Nice shot there. Nice shot. Went straight to the nose. But yeah, don't get me wrong. When I'm complaining like that, I'm not really mad or angry. It's just, I would have rather done it in the other way. And I mean, we win the game. This is complaining on a very high level here. Very much so. But we left somebody to die. And that just does feel bad. Get the point? It just feels bad. Knowing that there is one assault mech that is still falling behind a little bit. And people are just running away from one single big mech that we could use on the battlefield later. I mean, obviously, it was enough anyway. But get the point. Anyway, 2 killing blows, 9 assists, 1 kill, most damage dealt, 636 damage done, as well as 3 components destroyed. That's the first round, everybody. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing Canyon Network, we are playing Skirmish, that means that the enemies are coming from Charlie 5. Watch Charlie 5, guys, that's where the enemies are coming from. And they most likely... Okay, so let me quickly talk about that. They start here in Echo 5, Delta 5, low ground, and usually they make a wide circle in the low ground around here and get up this ramp. Charlie 4, Charlie 5 is gonna be the hot spot, but that also means that they will be on the high ground there rather quickly. Okay. Let's see. We are probably just taking a look over to the center and then shoot the hell out of the enemies. As you can see, Mauler there, Charlie 4, Charlie 5. That's where everybody is. They just start an NASCAR immediately. I want to get that guy. They're here, buddy. Oh, they have a Kodiak already. Okay. This is what we do. We dive down to cover by shooting him, or while shooting him. Kodiak left side is very damaged already. Let me do it once more. We have a quick draw there that we can shoot, no problem. You know what? I'm feeling safe here. This is my safe spot. Timber Wolf, almost getting caught. Right side on the timber, please. Right side on the timber. Echo. And the Kodiak is pushing up again. That means that, you know, they're doing a NASCAR, more or less. Oh yeah, show me your butt, baby. Good. Some solid damage. I have a good spot here. And the timber is hopefully alone. Yeah, people are going in now. Let's crush the timber wolf. Let's do that. Heat level is critical. So is my artillery strike level. Would have been great if we could just double tap here and didn't jam our autocannon. Alright, Kodiak is almost down. That's a cougar. Very good squishy target. And we are applying a lot of pressure on the enemies. Those missiles are from me though. Hi. We've met before. Which side also is your damaged one? Thank you not. Okay, we're still alive. Ah, Corsair! Let's get hell out of here. I think I'm a little bit too late for the NASCAR, so it seems. Yeah, we have to go in now. Let's make that corner here. Let's take that corner. And go in for you again. Why would you do that to me? That's nasty. We are down. Yeah, we are down by everything. We have nothing anymore. No! Come on, let's go ramming speed. Hello, quick draw. Come on, stay here. Stay here. I want to spot you. I want to kick you in the butt. Come on. Come on. Boom. Yeah. And once more. Aww. I think we actually dealt damage to his back there. All right. So, the enemies were partly very aggressive and partly very defensive. That means that we could engage them with all of our might while they were only half of the team in one spot. So, yeah. We still didn't get a killing blow. We had 10 assists, we got 3 killmoss damage dealt and about 700 damage done, but no killing blow. Anyway, that was your daily dose for today, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and if you want to support me, you can go down below to the description. There's the link to my Patreon page, and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.